Hi, this podcast is about graphing inverses. We've been talking a bunch about inverses in class, and this is really going to focus about just graphing inverses. So our goal is to take a graph of an existing function and using that graph, plot the inverse of that graph. First thing we're going to do though is we're going to take the help of tables. But we'll figure out very quickly how to do it just straight from graphs. So here we go. We've got 3x minus 2, which is a linear function. I've drawn the table out. I've also drawn out the linear line by taking two points, negative 2 comma negative 8 right here, and 3 comma 7 right there. I want you to pause me now and verify that the table as well as the line looks good to you with respect to the equation. Pause me now. Okay, back again. Now let's think about how you would get the table for the inverse function. Think about it. What would you do? Yep, you would swap the x column and the f of x column and get this red table right here with the swapped values. Let's try and draw the graph for the inverse function. And think about what kind of a function do you expect. Some of you might already think about it and already know, but let's discover. Here's negative 8 comma negative 2, negative 5 comma negative 1, negative 2 comma 0, 1 comma 1, 4 comma 2, and 7 comma 3. As you can tell, it is also a linear equation, a line, and here is the line that fits right in with those coordinate points. Now, how can I start with the blue line and get to the red line without having a table? Let me give you a hint. Recognize this green line. Which equation does it represent? Look at it. You can tell that it represents the y equal to x line. The blue, as you remember, is the f of x line, and the red is the f inverse of x line. What's the relationship between the blue and the red? If you stare close enough, you can see that when you reflect the blue line across the y equal to x line, you get the red f inverse of x line. That is it. That's the relationship between the two. You take the function line or the function graph that you have, and you just fold it across the y equal to x line, and you get your inverse function. But we got to verify one more time with another curve. Let's do that. Okay, here's another graph of now a quadratic, which is the x square, standard x square function, which is your blue table right here. As you can tell, all of the f of x values are just squares of the x value. What I did to get the inverse is just swap as usual. Now, let's test out that theory of trying to reflect across the green line, which is your y equal to x line. Here's your y equal to x line. So I'm going to take this part of the curve right here and reflect off of it, which is going to be my red line. So I'm going to try real hard to just try and reflect. I'm not going to be very good at this. And this part of the blue line, which is in the second quadrant, basically reflects off like so. Now let's test out the theory. Look at the x value 4 and notice that it has two outputs, negative 2 and 2. There are two fours in the x column. Is this a function? Is the f inverse of x a function in this case? No, because it doesn't pass the VLT, the vertical line test, and obviously you can see two inputs that have, that have two, rather, same input four that has two different outputs, which is a no-no for a function. So notice that you can always create the inverse by flipping across the y equal to x line, but it's not necessarily a function. So, summary, you always have inverses, but it may not be a function. Secondly, second summary, all you have to do is reflect across the y equal to x line and you get your inverse. Thank you, and we'll see you in class.